When Haiti collapsed in 2010, we had wealthy actors, actresses, and businessmen run a telethon asking for donations. They showed us the footage of the destruction. It was a natural disaster. The aftermath was badder, or should I say worse, than the first burst of Mother Earth finally asking for some collateral, scrambling, scrounging, scraping, just to make it until the Great Escape can free them. But what the hell is freedom? I ask you, suit and tie wearing, three-course meal preparing, African, Latino, European, American, flying in the comfort of a mechanical pelican. How far must you fly until you are properly satisfied with that lie you call freedom? See, I have seen them. Them being you and I, ordering supersized meals in the luxury of assembly line design, motorized transportation mechanisms, sitting on 29-inch wheels, 29-inch wheels, drive past products of the environment, boom, boom, booming, then wonder why they steal. Because from the very first grade, they became slaves immediately, whipped and chained by the masters of their subconscious. They hear it every day, do not be swayed by the nonsense, but the most naive will row, row, row their boat gently down the stream so false merrily until rise the head of a Loch Ness, all because this is what they want. This is what they crave. To be judged not by the contents of their character, but by the clothes on their backs, the model of their cars, and the amount of ice that they flaunt. I tell you, priorities are so out of order. But I have a dream that one day teens will no longer match their personalities to that of hip-hop performers, and that they will be thankful. Thankful, instead of hypnotized by the lives of people they've seen in magazines, the internet, and on cable, because we are all walking backwards. We want to be rechained and retrained to work daily, yet walk on strained legs, think as if brain dead, allow our wings to be clipped slowly while the man gains bread. Well, I refuse to be abused, misused, misunderstood, and excused from the table, because life is a test, not a journey or a fable. And failure results in discrimination from angels. So this poem is for colored and non-colored people who did not find gold at the end of their rainbows. But what they did find was something better. A kingdom in the sky, white wings, and a halo.
All right. All right.